Hi guys and welcome back to my channel. I have a video for you today and it's going to be on a bronzy kind of glowy look for the spring to kind of basically what I've started doing already is just kind of correcting under my eyes a little bit because I always feel like it's a different kind of tone to the rest of my skin color. So what I've done is I've just taken my Clinique Beyond Perfecting foundation and concealer and started concealing under my eyes a little bit. Then I am before I kind of start going in with my foundation kind of all over my skin, what I'm going to do is go in with this BB cream. It's one of those ones that I got in my Birchbox when I was subscribed to them and I absolutely loved it. And I just, it's one of those products that you discover and you never know you're going to discover, you just come across it. So it's a really good one and it's a really nice kind of bronzy toned colour, really adds a glow to your skin and it just literally blends in so well. It doesn't sit on my skin, it just really just blends in and leaves my skin with kind of a nice soft kind of glow to my skin without it looking kind of not blended in. So I'm going to apply some of that and I really wanted to go in. If you guys cannot find this one online, I will leave the name of it in the description box below. And I have found it online, I just haven't repurchased yet because this one's not finished. So it's called the Marcel BB Cream Golden Glow Illuminator. Yeah, so it's this one and what colour was it? I think that's the colour. And then if you cannot find that, then this one is a really, really understated one on YouTube actually. Not a lot of people talk about it. It's from Rimmel and it's the Good to Glow Highlighter Illuminator. It's the liquid illuminator and it's the one in, I have it in Soho Glow 003. It's a really good one if you can't find this one. It's quite similar in colour and texture and I think they do this in another two colours as well. So in their range they have three colours altogether. It's a really good one to pick up if you're just looking for that really nice light kind of glow to your skin rather than a powdered highlight or anything and you just want to go in and blend this with your foundation. It's a really good one. So it's the L'Oreal. Go in with my foundation in the areas that I want. I didn't use a primer today because I just feel like I don't really need it. I don't know, I feel like I'm not going to be wearing my makeup for long. So I'm not going to take too much. So I'm going to go in with my foundation brush, which I really love, which is the Anastasia one in number 4 I think, and it's their small blending brush. I obviously really need to get around to reviewing this. Please leave it in the comments if you want me to do that, if it will help, because this is an amazing brush. Like I think I've spoken about it in a favorites video, but I just feel like it's the perfect size for my face even under the eyes. And it just blends so well, like that I don't even pick up my beauty blender anymore. Just feel like this just kind of does the job. And I don't really, I mean, if I do need to blend it out to make it look a bit more natural, I'll probably just go in with my fingers. And I know a lot of people just do not like that feeling of using their fingers, but I just feel like it doesn't pull on my skin and leave those streaks. It just blends it really well and I just don't know how it does it. I think where the bristles are kind of really small but really soft. Yeah, I just love this brush so much. I'd highly recommend it. You can get this on Amazon really easily as well. And I think it's really, really affordable. I think it was about £8-9. So, and powder and then show you guys the next step. Another concealer, if you cannot afford this, I think this is about £25 for a foundation, but it lasts a really long time, so I do think per wear it's acceptable to be that price. But if you're looking for more of an affordable one, I feel like I found kind of a dupey, and recently Revlon Colourstay have reformulated their foundation and I think they're in pump form now, and I've recently gone back to it and I feel like these two very, very similar. They're high coverage, they last all day on your skin, doesn't crease up on me. The formulas seem very, very similar, so if you're looking for more of an affordable one, I think this is about £12-13 at the drugstore now, in Superdrugs and Boots. So If you want to try this and save like half your money and then going in for this, then this is a really good one. And if you're looking for a good concealer, then I always go back to my favorite concealer from the drugstore, and it's the Maybelline Fit Me. I think it's great for my skin type, for dry. If you have dry skin like me, then this is a really good one because it just really stays on really well. It's really creamy in formula, non-drying, and doesn't go into your kind of your fine lines and things like that. So it's a really good one if you have dry skin and your area under your eyes, you have lines, and as soon as you put concealer on, it's either too dry or the texture's not creamy enough. But this is a really, really good one. Highly recommend the Maybelline Fit Me, and even the Maybelline Fit Me foundation, I feel like it's a really, really good one that I feel like I need to test out again and just maybe go back to. I think I get the tube of it and then I use it till it's like finished, and then I just end up finding another foundation and testing out another one, like the Revlon one, like the Clinique one. I have literally been obsessed with and used nothing else since. I used to be obsessed with the Maybelline, no, what is it, the L'Oreal Infallible, and I don't use that anymore. I went through tubes of that, and it, you know, it's just one of those things. There's so many great foundations out there, but it's just finding one that you really, really love and sticking with it. But if you're looking one for dry skin, then the ones I've just gone over are really great for dry sensitive skin. Yeah, so I'm just gonna add that powder now, finally. Yeah, I guess I just feel in quite a chatty mood recently. Yeah. But I'm just going to add the powder where I need to, and then go in with bronzing, or I might even contour a little bit just to kind of bring some structure back in to my face, and maybe even my cheeks, and then my my cheekbones and everything. Right, oh, I just need to get a bit more out. Okay, so I'm just going to add a little bit here as well. So if I have lost a bit of that glow, what I'm going to do is I have something for that, and I can't wait to show you guys. I have quite a few different types of highlighters for you, so it's kind of a good blend of things. If you don't like liquidy kind of highlighters like I've shown you, then I have some powder ones coming up as well. So the next thing I am going to go in with I have a couple of bronzers for this look, and I feel like they all work. I do feel like they all work. So it's really just down to opinion, choice and everything like that for you guys. So I have this one, which is from H&M, and I think I recently used it in another Get Ready With Me. So I have this in Golden Honey, and it's the Solar Flare Bronzing Powder. Looks like this. It's a really neutral kind of bronzer, so if you are not into like contouring and bronzing too much, then this is a really nice one to start off with, because it's almost skin tone like if you're quite olive toned like me. Yeah, so this is a really good one to start with if you just want that extra kind of glow back into your skin, and you just want to bronze up your skin without contouring or anything, or even contouring with this would be fine. But if you don't want to do that, then I also have another one, which is the Bourjois Bronzing Primer. Now, I didn't know that if this actually works as a primer, because I've only used it a couple of times and I've not really noticed a difference in how long my bronzer lasts or my makeup lasts. But the first couple of times actually I used this, I didn't like this. But I think what they're trying to do is kind of make it a dupe, so it looks like this, so it's more of a liquidy, you know, wet based kind of bronzer. So it's kind of like along the lines of the Chanel de Soleil bronzing glow thing, the liquid formation. So if you're into the Chanel de Soleil and you cannot afford that price point, like it's like £50 or something like that, and it was really, really big on YouTube at one point. If you cannot afford that but you want to try out something similar to that, then Bourjois obviously have this, and I think that this is not new, it's quite an older, but I've dug it out of my collection, so I think it's been out for about a year, and I don't hear many YouTubers talk about it, so I don't know whether it's just one of those products that are not good and no one wanted to speak about it, or it is good and it's a hidden gem, so it's not raved about enough. So it says it's a tinting smoothing primer but in a bronzing form. Yeah, so it's the Base Le Sans Soleil. Oh, I think it sounds so high end. Yeah, so I'm just going to take that, and I'm actually How should I do this? I think I might just start contouring this and see how I go with my foundation brush. So I'm just gonna dip that in and then, oh, don't hurt me, hope that's not too much. And then I'm just gonna take it on my contours. So I am gonna go in with the bronzer in a minute, like the powder one. I might even go in with the H&M one and just see how I go. But I actually quite like that. I hope it's not taking off my foundation. Okay, I feel like it is. Affect my skin in any ways. I do feel like I'm a lot more bronzier now, but I am going to go in with, just to look that extra bit more glowy, I'm just going to go in and bronze up my skin with my bronzer. I have this one from Elizabeth Arden, which I've probably shown you guys like way too many times, but I just do love it. I'll use some of this as well just to show you guys how it looks on the skin, but I'm just going to blend this out a little bit more. Just so I just want it to look really seamless and blended in. Yeah, I do like it, but I'm just worried about that scent. I hope it's not gonna break me out. If you guys have sensitive skin, then Bourjois products are very heavily scented. Like, I stopped using their chocolate bar bronzer because I feel like it was just too heavy for my skin and the scent in it just broke me out. Yeah, so I just stay clear of that if you have sensitive skin. I feel like that's a lot more blended in now. Yeah, I feel like the light's going a little bit more dim at the moment, so I will just go in with this bronzer from H&M, yeah, and then just bronze up my skin where I want to. You guys don't have to bronze up like I do. I'm not even an expert in bronzing up or contouring, but this is just like how I like to warm up my skin. So yeah, I do feel like this is a really nice neutral colour to have for this time of year. It's not like too heavy. I feel like it matches my skin tone. It has a tiny bit of an orange kind of undertone, but not too much that I don't think I can get away with it. Yeah, I feel like I like this combination. Right, I'm just going to take a little bit on my temples, just so it's all kind of evened out and I'm more bronzed up. You guys can completely skip this step as well. You don't have to bronze up like I am. You can just go on to just highlighting if that's what you like to do. I actually sometimes, for my work day to day, I don't actually bronze. I don't use bronzer at work. I feel like I don't want to look like I have too much makeup on, so I just sometimes take a little bit of my highlighter that I'm going to show you and use it in areas where I just want that little bit of a glow. So I don't ever bronze for work. I feel like it's too much makeup for me, but each to their own. You guys can bronze up if you want to bronze up, but yeah, I think that's fine now. And the reason I like using the Elizabeth Arden bronzer is because it has like, and I think I said this before, it has like tiny, and look, literally I've hit pan and I'm just wondering where I'm gonna find this again. I'm gonna look online for it, or maybe TK Maxx, because Elizabeth Arden products are kind of hard to find, come by, if especially if these are like limited edition ones, and they only do them limited edition. So I'm gonna see if I can find something similar at their counter as well, because I do feel like Elizabeth Arden are just so underrated. Some of their products are nothing like, they're unique, they're nothing like any other kind of brand. Like, I feel like Dior have similar products to them, but just not as similar but not like as good either. So these have like tiny specks of pinks and browns and whites, and I feel like it, when it's mixed together, it just creates this beautiful kind of luminosity with a really nice kind of how do I describe it, like specks of kind of gold dust, but you're shimmery, but you're not like a glitter ball shimmery, or you know, it's a really nice kind of glow to the skin to have. So I'm just going to take it everywhere where I kind of bronzed, and just adds a really nice kind of glow. So I think some bronzers try and add that, so it's like a glittery bronze, but it just doesn't work. I've tried so many drugstore high-end bronzers that have glitter in them and they just don't work. I would prefer to go for just like a matte bronzer, but this one really does work, and I'll show you just like a little close-up of the tiny specks in it. I just think it's so, so pretty, but it just looks great on the skin as well. It doesn't just, it blends in really well. It just doesn't sit on my skin. So Oh, okay. So is that too much? Sometimes when you're putting on makeup, you just don't know when to stop. It's just one of those things, I suppose. But yeah, I'm just gonna even this all out and make sure it's not. I think bronzing's like my favorite part. It just brings bringing that glow to your skin. It's just. And highlighting. Don't forget highlighting. Okay, so I would like to tell you guys, because I know this is kind of like a chatty kind of get rid of with me. I would love to tell you about my week, but really, it was just one of those hectic weeks at work where you just can't wait to get to the end of it. And every day after school, it's just been manic, like trying to get the kids into a routine of getting them ready for school again for the following day. And we've had rugby and PE kids coming home all mucky. You just really don't want to know about all the boring mum stuff that goes in to, yeah, two wonderful children. But yeah, it's just been one of those weeks which have been so manic, and I just have not had any time at all. I feel like it does probably sound like an excuse, but I generally feel like I don't have enough time to film, and by the time it just builds up and builds up, it's like, oh, you're just so far, you know, when you watch other people's YouTube videos and you're like, I'm so far gone, like, how will I catch up with making my videos and a great standard to that person's video, even though I know I shouldn't be doing that? But yes, I do. So I ca have a couple of highlighters. Where did I put them? So I have this one and this one, and I have a couple that I would like, yeah, that I will fill in my brows as well. Yeah, so bronzer's done. Yes, I'll go in with my highlight now, and I've been used, this is my most used one recently. So it's this one from MUA, and it's the, I think I mentioned this in another video, I feel like I have, or I've mentioned it to someone because someone was asking for a good highlighter to recommend. So this is the one in Glowbeam. It's the liquid highlight cushion. I think this is the only color they have in their collection at the moment, and I think it's about £4 or £5, which I think is really good. It was in an offer when I bought it, so I think it was about £4 when I bought it, which I feel like is a really affordable drugstore price. Like, you cannot, I don't think any other brand, drugstore brand, are selling highlighters in a cushion form at the moment, but don't quote me on that. I just don't, haven't seen. Oh, actually, I feel like L'Oreal have just come out with a cushion bronzer. Yeah, like they had the cushion foundation, and now I think they've come out with a cushion bronzer, but not a highlighter. So I was so intrigued when this came out, and I think Fleur raved about it and said she loved it. So that's why I went and bought it, and I absolutely love it. I used to dip my beauty blender in this and then blend it out, but now I just use my finger. I just pop my finger in it. I know, unhygienic, and I just start glowing wherever I want. It is a very, I don't know, I feel like this is versatile. I feel like this will work on paler skin tones or lighter complexions. I feel like it will give you a really nice soft glow because it's so sheer, because it's a cushion type highlighter. It just blends into your skin really well. So because it's so sheer, I just feel like it will work for different skin tones. So this is what I do. I just blend it in with my fingers on my highest points of my cheekbones, and then my nose, and I just love taking it everywhere where I just want to look a little bit more fresh and glowy. You can even take it on your brows. I am gonna be using eyeshadow, so yeah, so I'm just gonna take it everywhere I need. And I feel like it works best that way. And I can just, I'll just, oh, well, I wanted to show you guys. Let's see if I can. So it's just a really nice kind of sheer kind of glow. It's not like a really bronzy, bronzing, like a really dark golden bronze. It's more of a sheer kind of bronzy tone. Bronzer, teenager, like we all had this. I feel like I had it anyway, and it was just something I probably bought about a year ago, and I still use it. I use it on my eyes on a daily basis just to give my eyes like a tiny bit of color, and I feel like it really matches my skin tone. I use more of the bottom two shades, and I just blend those two together and then put it all over my lid. So I'm going to start with that type of base. Okay, so now, so what was I saying? Yes, yeah, so I'm just going to take this and just apply it to my eyelid. So this is the Shimmer Waves in shade bronze. Yeah, so from the Body Shop. And I'm just going to take that and then just apply it literally all over my lids. And it just creates a really nice kind of glowy, how would I describe it? It's a very light bronze, a light bronzy type. And I just literally, I'm going to take that all over my lids today. Brows done recently, I think a couple of days ago, and I feel like it's literally, you know when you tell someone like, I want my eyebrows like thick, you know, that thick Instagram look. Oh yes, I know, I understand. No, she literally goes in and massacres them and like thins them till like they look like a line. So I'm going to draw them in a little bit. Well, I'm still going to follow the shape of my brow, but yeah, just kind of try and make them look more there. Yeah, kind of define them a little bit more today. Okay, so that's all blended in, and it just leaves a really nice kind of subtle glow. Really matches the whole look. You could leave it here and just go in with mascara, but I am just going to go in with another colour, and it's this one from the Elizabeth Arden, no, the Estee Lauder Bronze Goddess palette, and I'm going to go in with this really dark shade here. It's very pigmented, so what I'm going to try and do is just take a little bit at a time, and yeah, it's very pigmented, so I'm just going to be extra careful that there's not too much on there. And I'm just taking that kind of in the mid section, like in my crease area, and just blending it out in my crease and just flicking it out. Yeah, so I'm just taking it in my crease and just going back and forth with it really, and just rolling it out just so it blends out. I just feel like it adds that little bit more intensity and depth to the eyes, and yeah, well, I hope it does. yeah, so I'm just going to keep doing that and then build up the colour, and yeah, I really like this colour, but I feel like it's very pigmented, so you have to be careful with how much you have on the brush. So again, just adding it to the crease and just blending it outwards. And I'm just going to keep going with that, and I am going to take that colour underneath as well. Okay, and now all I've done is I've taken this kind of gold colour from the same palette. Yes, I kind of like this really light gold colour, and I've just taken my finger, dipped it in there, yeah, and I'm just going to apply that to my lid. So I'm just literally going to apply it, not all over, just like the lower part of my lid. Yeah, and I just feel like it looks really pretty, kind of still that glowy type of look. It will all come together once the mascara kind of goes on, but yeah, I just really love this look. And it's really easy. I feel like there's not too many colours on there, but yeah, I feel like these colours work really well. They're really pigmented, they're really sheeny colours, they're not easy to blend. I mean, they're easy to blend, so it's nice to kind of play about with colours as well. Not use too many tools, like I'm using my finger, I'm not using too many brushes to blend. Yeah, so I'm just going to see if it's matching on both sides. Like this side needs a little bit more. Should I take this one? I'm going to take this smudgy kind of brush, and it's from e.l.f. I think, it's their contour brush, and I'm going to take that dark colour that I put into my crease and just brush it out underneath, kind of smudge it out underneath, and I'm just going to tap off as much as I can, because like I said, it's very pigmented, so taking a little at a time will help you to know how much to kind of put on or how much you want on. So it's just very pigmented, it almost kind of lines your lips, aligns your eyes, and yeah, just brings them out a little bit more. Allows it to be more defined, but without kind of using a liner. So powder just makes it look a little bit more softer. So I'm just going to take it underneath. Okay, so now the eyes are finished. So I have both on. I hope that is kind of showing up Yeah, so now I'm just going to fill in my brows. I've done this one already. Doesn't look too bad. I've just taken Tanya Burr's, this is her older collection. I think this is the first collection she came out with, and I still have it and I still love it. It's the Tanya Burr Cosmetics Fairy Tale Eye Palette. If you guys have this, then if you use the black in it, if you have dark eyebrows like me, I have black eyebrows. But I'm recently been looking into other kind of eyebrow products and wanting to find something that's a really dark brown. So I had a look at my Anastasia one and I feel like it's too light for me, but I will give it a review or a test out. Let me know if you guys want to see something like that and I can do a review on that one. And yeah, hopefully it works, because like using a darker brown might just make my eyebrows look a little bit less darker. And I think that's what I want. I do want definition, but sometimes I feel like with really dark eyebrows and not feeling the really defined brow, I suppose I feel like I want something different now. But I'm just gonna literally follow the shape of my brows, actually massacred. Yeah, now that I'm gonna have to wait for them to kind of thicken out. But maybe enjoy not having to get my eyebrows done as quick as I usually would. So it will take a while for them to kind of grow out, so maybe it's gonna be a lot more low maintenance, if that makes sense. So I'm just gonna follow the little hairs basically and just make them look a bit more defined. So I'm just following the shape of my brow and just going over all of that, if that makes sense. Yeah. Okay, all right. Feel like they're a bit too defined. Okay, now I'm just gonna go in with mascara and yeah, so then the eyes kind of start to look a bit more there. I don't know what that means. I'm using this Clinique one and I really love this one, but I do feel like it's drying out on me quite quick, so okay, finally have mascara done, eyebrows done. Now last thing I'm gonna do is lips. I'm gonna go in with the lip liner first, or I could go in with this kind of bronzy color, cinnamon bronze, and we'll see how we go. So I'm just gonna go ahead and try and fill in my lips. Fill in my lips. Yeah, I really like this one. Where's my accent changing? Okay, I think I might just top it up with that cinnamon bronze a little bit. Okay. Is that better? I feel like this is better. I prefer this. Don't take into account that I feel like I just had a cat. Do take into account that my lips are quite dry at the moment. Okay. Yeah. So I did want to wear quite a moisturizing lip. Yeah, I still feel like it's not right. I don't know. Let me know what you guys think. But yeah, I'm gonna leave it there, and I don't want something too bright and bold for the lips. I think I'm just gonna leave this pinky toned color. Maybe add a touch of this matte, I don't know. Feel like that's a little bit better. Okay. It's not super defined, I know. But I don't really want it to be, I suppose, because I made the eyes quite smoky and rough and nothing too kind of. Yeah, okay, so I think, yeah, ignore the hair. But yeah, I think that's the finished makeup look, and then I'm just going to try and brush through my hair and put some sort of gel through it or something, or a mousse, just to make it look a bit more less fizz-free. Okay guys, so this is the ignore kind of the dry lips, but yeah, this is the finished makeup look. Yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I know it's been probably super long, but yeah, just wanted to give you a nice kind of makeup look for the spring, summer, nice and bronze and kind of glowy, fresh kind of skin, if that makes. Yeah, I hope it helped and everything, and maybe I could do an updated kind of skincare routine for you guys on what I'm using on my skin to keep it nice and fresh and clear even, and give you an idea on all the the skincare products I'm using, because as well as doing makeup looks and stuff, I feel like you do always need a good base to start with. I've feel like it's really, really important to take care of your skin. So if you guys would like to see a upcoming video on skincare routine and what products I use on my skin, then just leave it in the comments below. I feel like my nose is running. I don't know whether I'm coming down with a cold or something, but I feel like it's been like this all day. But yeah, just let me know, and I'll leave some pictures of this finished makeup look to show you guys what it looks like in photos. But yeah, I hope that's coming up. And then the eyes, yeah, super kind of glowy gold, glowy eyes. Yeah, so I hope you guys, I already said that, and I will see you all next time, guys. Thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. It's free to subscribe. Just hit on the subscribe button below and it will do it all for you. And I will see you all next time. Thanks, guys. Bye.